We believe that the health of one can mean the health of many. We believe that a small act today can have a big impact tomorrow. At Benefis Health System, we are building a state-of-the-art women's and children's center because we believe the best way to support our community is by caring for our caregivers and safeguarding our future. And we're asking you to join us because we believe that a strong community is something we can only achieve together. Give today by visiting benefis.org/foundation. Hear from some of the people who are passionate about the vitality of a center dedicated to caring for the women and children of our community.
With the advent of the Women and Children's Center, we're actually speaking to actually creating a medical home and bringing the neuropsychologist, the child psychiatrist, the pediatrician that's generating the referral, and the family practice doc that's taking care of the family. We're bringing them together in a collaborative way because together we're actually stronger. Although in Montana we don't have the resources that other states have, we have a lot of invested providers. And if we can figure out how to create a continuum of care with the services that we have, we will definitely see change in our community.
So to my understanding, there's nothing like this that, you know, in the state available, combining these needs. And if you look at other, you know, other states nationwide, there are many of these. And to be able to offer that to our state would be an excellent opportunity.
Women actually are the interface for healthcare for their families. 1 in 10 women is caring for an elderly parent. Women are caring for their partners, they're caring for their children, they're caring for their husbands. Creating a center that actually recognizes this and shifts the burden away from women, and creating a service that actually is actually geared to providing care to the family, is a truly revolutionary concept that doesn't exist anywhere else in this state.
I want a woman to walk into this building and feel like she is taking the reins on her family's health, and that she is being responsible and that she's being proactive. It's the right thing to do, and so I think environments can do that. I think we can make a welcome area. I think it can feel natural and comfortable, and I think it can have easy ways of navigating it, and I think it can be exciting and interactive for kids. And so I think that's why the physical environment really adds to the experience.
As a provider, you adapt to your surroundings and give your best at any given moment. So really the ultimate goal is to design the building around our patients.
Co-location. Everybody loves going to TJ's to get an item and going to Target to get an item. Families don't enjoy that. The difference is when I'm on the weekend and I'm on my Saturday and I'm doing my things, this is a waste of my time. But in medicine, we're talking about waste of capital. We're talking about longer time to diagnosis, longer time to treatment, and lesser outcomes. Although it seems silly, the co-location of services increases patient satisfaction. It decreases risk in the ER, and it creates more optimism for our patients because we're creating a social network. We're really talking about creating a medical home for people. And that's where relationships with children develop, and that's where they thrive. And this is the place.
To be able to coordinate, my appointment with, or my lab draw with, my child's appointment, to be able to say, okay, I'm going to get to see my pediatrician and then go to the speech therapist for my speech appointment in the same spot and not have to move my entire family and car seat and stroller and everything. So just from the physical convenience, it's going to be important for the community.
When we're talking about the medical home, we're talking about creating a holding environment for our families. The families in Great Falls have a lot of complexity because we're missing some subspecialties and some of our subspecialties are overburdened. And what that means is that we need that ability to collaborate and be together.
So with this Women's and Children's Center, I really envision taking a couple from the very beginning to the very end. And with that meaning, it's a very personal, private journey. There's a lot of ups and downs. But in the end, I want to bring them in, do an ultrasound, have a big screen on the wall, and be able to show them their baby for the first time.
We have experiences with patients that aren't always comfortable and aren't always the most joyful when we have to tell them that they have had the loss of a pregnancy, or when we have to break the news that they have breast cancer. And then we go on that journey all the way through it with them. So this building really is going to be a building of firsts, a first for our patients and first for us.
This building is so much more than walls. This building is going to it has some of the moments in here that you never forget. You never forget getting that feedback on your health as a woman. You don't forget that moment you decide you want to conceive. You don't forget hearing your baby's heartbeat for the first time. Or when you're really nervous and don't know if your kid's healthy or not. So I think this sticks with you. I think it's really important for that reason.
The new Women's and Children's Center is a center intended to benefit and improve the lives of all the women in our community. And almost every family has a woman in it, so it's an opportunity for us to come together to support those women.
We're talking about investing in human capital. We're talking about investing in potential.
So there's a large area that we serve. And there's, if you put all the children together that are in those communities, that is our future. Those are, you know, those next generations are going to be what, you know, becomes the next, you know, generation in terms of workforce, and the next generation in terms of, you know, accessing, you know, future care, what the future brings for Montana. Getting them that foundation started, knowing with children, it's a lifelong impact. You know, any investment made is an investment that's going to pay itself forward that much more.